People drown in a minute. You think they're sweet and they just sink, so you can't really leave that up to chance.
Five or six more people just lost their feet and started to panic.
Oi! Oi! Go in! Go in!
There are now six swimmers in trouble and only one lifeguard.
I saw him go in. I was like, oh, this is on. I started thinking I might have to go in here.
Yeah, central to Jethro.
Backup is 800 metres away at the north end.
Mate, there's a few more heads down there. It might even be worth just heading down that way, mate.
Usually the horn's really useful to clear a path, but on this day the horn wasn't working.
I was looking at other people in trouble thinking, geez, we need a few more lifeguards out here. Hey, buddy, oi, oi! Oi, swim to me, swim to me.
A man further in struggles to stay afloat. Trainee lifeguard Berkey is off duty and faced with a decision.
I knew I had to go.
But has the new recruit left his run too late?
Mate, that guy was drowning.
Rip intensifies, yet more swimmers are sucked out.
Yeah, central to north rhino. There's about five heads now, so worth going in when you get there.
You've got to get on the board. Lay off your stomach. Stomach. No.
Copy. Don't go in.
Three times out of the water.
Jethro finally arrives with first-year Bondi lifeguard Jack. Reidy, Berkey and a volunteer lifesaver manage five patients. Two more swimmers cling to a small bodyboard.
Keep that hand only the buggy, but let me know.
Jack heads for the two swimmers who are waving when Jules identifies yet another person in trouble.
There's a chick close to shore who's, like, practically
drowning. Wait.
You can't ignore when people are in distress.
PA Jack and tell him to turn around and go for the chick into his right. She's the priority.
There's now only one lifeguard left on the entire beach.
By the time I grabbed the megaphone, Jack had gone past it. I just had to get in there.
Jethro's going in.
People drown in a minute. You think they're sweet and they just sink, so you can't really leave that up to chance.
Escalated quickly.
Bruno Chent is visiting from Hong Kong with his family.
Huh? We were looking for him on the wrong spot the whole time.
I am on the pedal. I try to swim as hard as I can. My kids are also here, so I'm really happy.
My nasty. Glad you're okay.
This is my fifth summer on the beach. You know, it's time for me to really step up. We've got a lot of new, inexperienced lifeguards, and you know, that puts me in a position to be someone to look up to.
No more swimming in the south corner.
For millions of Australians, the surf is a major part of their lives. Swimming, surfing, body surfing. But for every expert, there are many more novices. And for a handful of visitors, today could well be their first time in the ocean. Identifying where the rips are can take years of experience.
Please come out of the water, then, swimmers.
And some visitors have never even heard of a rip.
So I'm sitting down on the water's edge with Deano and we kind of noticed that the rip on the other side of the flags had flared up. So I guess I was keeping an extra eye on it and then suddenly there's a group of people, three or four people in trouble.
Oh, terrible, those two guys are coming.
Dude, that's full on drowning, eh?
For weak swimmers, even the mildest rip can be deadly.
Once we radioed it through and the boys were looking at it through the binos and we're making our way down in the buggy, they came back with a fair bit of urgency saying we really needed to get in.
Surfers on a nearby sandbank are oblivious to the emergency taking place just metres away.
Yeah, get out there, boys, they're going.
In between the two sets, it's like it's a lake there and obviously just can't swim a stroke.
The men could swim to the safety of a shallow sandbank, just metres to their right. But with no surf experience, they're helpless.
watching it, it's like a car crash. You don't want to see it, but you got to watch it, you know. If they go under, you've got to watch where they last went under so then the guys can respond. The worst thing about being a lifeguard is sitting in that tower and watching someone drown right in front of you and there's nothing you can do about it.
This guy was like under and not coming back up again. And I said, you know, I'm here to help you. He literally couldn't even dog paddle over to me. The strength to try and get his arms out of the water just wasn't there.
I thought someone's gonna drown here.
It's just a few meters to the board, but the men can barely swim. They're all members of the same family, originally from Iraq.
For me, knowing what it looks like when someone's drowning, that guy was drowning.
Don't go in the ocean unless you know how to swim. Seriously.
10 meters to the north, he would have been in waist depth water.
He had the stroke where you try and swim and you, as you lift yourself up out of the water, you send yourself back underwater, you know. All he had to do was stop trying to swim and he would have been fine.
Scary, like, you see how people drown up and down the coast and these isolated beaches, go for a swim, no one around, drop off, dude.
The family spokesman is 5-year-old Savrin.
This is Sahir, he's my dad. This is Ivan, and I'm Savrin. My family was born in Iraq. I don't know anything about Iraq because I was born here, so it's actually their part, not my part. Like, I'm not so good, Dilu.
Good. Despite the family's almost deadly introduction to Bondi, Savrin isn't deterred.
It's a good beach.
One woman is barely standing, but Chapo passes her to reach two other people farther out.
Hey.
The pair from Korea would be difficult to bring in at once.
Probably does need a hand. We got to keep a few of us on the beach here because if something was to happen down south, then there's, you know, then there's just no one here.
Jackson notices two more people in a separate rip, but must collect another rescue board.
Yeah, there's two in backpackers. They're sitting on. Is he heading over?
I don't think he's got the message.
Chapo offloads the two young Koreans in shallow water.
They were right on the shore and I just thought they'd be fine.
But seconds later, and the pair have walked back into the deep water of the rip.
They weren't fine, so I had to go get them a bit closer to shore and that took more time.
The situation stops Chapo from getting to the two other people farther out.
I had to go and make another rescue because I could hear these two big guys drowning behind me, screaming.
Struggling to understand Chapo's instruction, the pair think he is asking them to get back on the board.
I just thought they'd let go.
Seeing the situation, Mario arrives from the north end.
As we're getting closer, a surfer got these two people.
Thank you, Lolly.
As they were going under, you know, so quick.
One of you come here.
I could see that they were in big trouble, and I wasn't surprised they were completely exhausted.
I was paddling the guy in, and he was so scared. They crossed in half. He thought he was dying.
Oh,
that you can get out the swimming pool. Just be careful, all right?
Yeah.
저 들어가고 있었는데 처음에 발이 닿았는데 점점 깊어지더니 뒤로 나오려고 하니까 발이 안 닿아서 계속 파도에 휩쓸려 갔어요. 그러다가 여러분께서 살려주셨어요.
You could just see in their expression that it was thank you very much, you just saved our lives and it was great.
You're a lucky guy.